online education for the English community. Okay, so student, we are started with the lesson circle. In our last lecture, we are completed practice set 3.2. Yeah, myself Bhagyashree Pardeshi, and on the last Monday, since we are not able to conduct the lecture, Madhuri ma'am have conducted the lecture, and she has taken about the arc, and also she has completed with the practice set 3.3. So we are going to take the next part of that. Okay, so let's start here. Okay, so today we are again starting with the circle only. So before starting with the next part, let's quickly revise what was taken by Madhuri ma'am, the definitions or what is meant by this, that we are going to see since we required in the practice set 3.4 this also. So the topic which she has taken, that is the arc of a circle. Now what is mean by arc of a circle? So you have seen already, look here, this circle we are having here. In this circle, this segment AB is nothing but, you know, which passes from the circle, that is called as a second here, means which touching the circle at both the ends and passing from that is called as second. And if you look properly, because of this second, it is divided in two parts. This is the one part is about the center. One part is containing the center and other part is here. Okay, this is one part. This is AYB. So this is nothing but one of the arc. Again, this next boundary is nothing but the another part of the circle. So these two are called as the arc of a circle. Simply, it is a boundary of a circle which has get divided because of the second. The two boundaries divided by the second are simply called as the arc of a circle, and which consists the center. जिसके पास center होता है, that is called as the major arc. Look here, for this arc AYB, which is this arc AYB, since it consisting the center, it is consisting. Therefore, this is called as the major arc, and the remaining part, that is this arc AXB. Since it is not containing the circle, it is called as the minor arc. Okay, so this has you already completed. So simply this is about the arc. Then that same way, the types of arc, the major arc and the minor arc. If the center of a circle is on the side of the second, then the arc on that side of the center is called as major arc. And minor arc is simply the arc which is on the other side of the center. It's called as the minor arc. Okay, so this part is the major arc, and this part is the minor arc. The next which was taken was the central angle. Now, pay attention to here, since we have to use this central arc. Now, central angle. If you look properly, this is the center of a circle. If we consider center of a circle as the vertex of the angle, then we call that angle as the center angle. Look here, C is the center, and if I am containing the angle ACB, which angle I am considering? Angle ACB. We are considering the angle ACB. Therefore, this angle ACB is simply called as the central angle here. And again, now here, if you look properly, since because of the second, the center circle is not divided into two parts, but if we take the two arms, that is arm AC and arm BC, because of this, the center we are containing. And if you look properly, this is the smaller part, so this is called as the minor arc, and this is the bigger portion, so that is called as the major arc. Okay, so simply center angle means, if it contains the center of a circle, then to that we will call as a center angle. Then major of arc, how to measure the arcs here? So it is very, very easy. Major of a minor arc first. Minor arc is equal to the major of corresponding center angle. Jo bhi center angle hoga, whatever will be the measurement of a center angle. For example, if I am taking this, suppose we are having this circle here, and with this, now if you look here, we are having a circle here, and because of this circle, for this circle we have drawn a major arc as well as a minor arc. And for this central arc, this minor arc is created, right? This minor arc AB has been created because of this center C. So this, the measurement of this minor arc is nothing but equals to the same as the measurement of central angle. Is center angle ke wajah se, is angle ke wajah se ye form hua. Because of which angle? This angle. Because of this angle C, this arc AB has been formed. Suppose agar is arc ki measurement, is angle ki measurement 30 degree, then we will say that the measurement of arc AB is also equals to 30 degree. So it is equal to the measure of center angle. Then major arc, jo bigger arc hai, that is this arc AB. Ab iski measurement kya hai? All of you know that the measure of a circle, a complete circle, is nothing but 360 degree, right? So 360 degree minus simply the measure of minor arc is nothing but the measure of major arc. In this way, you will get the measurement of a major arc. It's very easy. Minor arc is equals to measure of center angle, and major arc is equals to 360 minus measure of minor arc. And this simply semicircle, all of you knows that it is nothing but 180 degree. Jo bhi arc semicircular mein aata hai, that is equals to 180 degree. And the measure of a complete circle is 360 degree. So remember this we had to use here. Okay, so now let's start with the today's topic, the inscribed angle. Okay, so what is mean by inscribed angle? Now pay attention here. So what it says, C is the center of a circle. Look here, we are having a circle with center C. The vertex D of angle, are yaar PDQ yahan pe maine B le liya, just a minute. Ye hai P and this is okay. Then the vertex D of angle PDQ lies on the circle. Also the arms of this angle PDQ, the arms of this angle PDQ intersects the circle in point P and in point Q here. Intersecting the circle at point P and at point Q here. So such an angle is simply called as the inscribed angle in the circle or in the arc. Isko kya bolenge hum? This angle is inscribed in the circle or in the arc. Means simply, agar aap simply definition dekhoge, to whatever circle we are getting, if all the three vertex of the circle, these are the three vertex of the angle D, P and B, all the three vertex is lying on the circle, is lying on the boundary of the circle, so this type of angle we simply call as a inscribed angle. Or inscribed kahan pe, it is inscribed in the arc, or it is inscribed in the circle, it is inscribed in this arc. Look here, it is inscribed in this angle arc, and also it is inscribed inside the circle, therefore it is called as inscribed angle. Okay, suppose I'm drawing something like this. Okay, if you look properly, and if I want to consider this consider an angle here, which angle I'm going to consider here? Agar main ye angle consider kar liye. So if you look properly, the vertex of this angle, suppose this is P, this is Q, and this is suppose if you see the vertex of the all the three vertex of this angle is lying on the boundary of the circle. So therefore, this type of angles are called as inscribed angle. Okay, clear everyone? Inscribed angle mein kisi kuch puchna hai? Here it is say in this figure the angle ADB. It's inscribed in the arc ADB. Kis arc mein this? It is inscribed in this arc. Okay, want to ask anything? Nothing? Okay. So, we hope so. Sabko inscribed angle achche se samajh mein aaya hai. So, now let's see. Intercepted arc. What does it mean by intercepted arc here? So, simply, the arc of a circle that lies in the interior of this angle ADB is an arc intercepted by ADB. Means, if you look properly, because of this angle ADB, is arc ke andar, is angle ke andar, this arc AB is dikh raha hai. Because of this angle, this arc AB has been formed right here. So this arc AB is called as intercepted arc. This is called as the intercepted arc by this angle ADB. Simply, just remember, whatever angle is formed here, because of this angle, whichever arc is inside that angle, or jo uske आर्म्स के एंड पॉइंट्स में आ रहा है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द इंटरसेप्टेड आर्क. ओके एवरीवन क्लियर? इंस्क्राइब एंगल एंड इंटरसेप्टेड आर्क. ओके होप सो दिस इज वेरी क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. Okay, now the one of the important theorem, that is nothing but the inscribe angle theorem. It is very important because we have to use this theorem while solving many examples here. So let's see what is this theorem here. Okay, so what it says, the major the major of an inscribed angle is half of the major of the arc intercepted by it. Okay, it's very very easy, student. तो आपको क्या याद रखना है? The major of the inscribed angle means, suppose this angle is the inscribed angle, then what we are saying, it is half. किसके half है ये? It is half of the major of the arc intercepted by it. Which arc is intercepted by this? The arc which is intercepted by this is nothing but this arc. This arc B D C. Look here, because of this angle A. This arc BDC is intercepted. यहाँ पे क्या बोल रहा है? The measurement of this arc. Look here. The measurement of this angle BAC is nothing but half the measurement of arc BDC. This is nothing but your inscribed angle theorem. Here. So this we have to remember very well. क्योंकि यही हमें examples में use करना है. So what it says? The major of an inscribed angle is half of the major of the arc intercepted by it. Very very easy, बहुत simple है, आसानी से याद रह जाता है. So let's try to prove this one. So before proving, what we require? We require the given. Again, we don't have the figures. So firstly, draw the figure, draw an angle inscribed in the circle and the arc intercepted by it. Then we are written the given in a circle with center O, angle BAC. जो भी आपने figure में लिखा होगा, that we are taking here. Angle BAC is inscribed in the arc BAC. Right here, हाँ. Inscribe बोलो तो inscribe किसमें आता है? The bigger part में. इसमें inscribe आया हो किसमें? BAC में. It is inscribe and this and intercepted जो बोला है मैं उसके वजह से जो form हुआ है this form that is called as the intercept. So arc BDC is intercepted by this angle here. Okay. तो ये था गिवन थिंग. देन नेक्स्ट व्हाट वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द इंस्क्राइब एंगल द इंस्क्राइब इज बीएस ऑफ द मेजर ऑफ आर्क इंटरसेप्टेड बाय दैट इज मेजर ऑफ आर्क बीडीसी. ओके तो आपको प्रूव करना है कि ये वाला आर्क एंगल आर्क के हाफ है. तो फॉर प्रूविंग दिस व्हाट वी हैव डन हियर, तो सिंपली फर्स्टली वी आर डूइंग द कंस्ट्रक्शन. इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन व्हाट वी हैव डन, ड्रॉ एओ, इट इंटरसेक्ट द सर्कल एट पॉइंट ई. एओ को ड्रॉ किया, वो सर्कल को ई में इंटरसेक्ट कर रहा है. एंड ऑल्सो वी आर ड्रॉन दिस रेडियस ओसी. ओके सिर्फ दिस कंस्ट्रक्शन वी आर डन. सो लेट्स सी हाउ टू प्रूव दिस वन. सो हियर ठीक है, तो व्हाट इज डन हियर, वी आर कंसीडर द ट्रायंगल एओसी. देन इन द ट्रायंगल एओसी OA and OC are the same. Why these are same? Because this is nothing but the radius of the same circle. Now, if in a triangle the two sides are congruent, then we simply say that the two angles opposite the two sides are also congruent. Why? Because of the theorem of the isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle के हिसाब से हमने देखा कि AOC and the next angle OCA both are equal. That is this one. Which angle? This one, AOC. ये दोनों equal. This is the radius OA and OC. Radius are equal. Therefore, this angle, angle OAC, and the next angle OC, both are also equal. तो हमने क्या किया? इसका measurement हमने consider कर लिया. This is equals to X here. So we say that the measurement of both the angle is equals to X. Now, angle EOC. Is equals to OAC plus OCA. Why? Because this is the exterior angle theorem. Ab exterior angle theorem, what it says? Look here. If I am having a triangle here, triangle to nahi hai. Theek hai. Let me draw a triangle here. something. Something I drawn like this way. Now if you look here, this angle is touching to the triangle only. तो इसकी मेज में जो भी रहती है ना, ये इसके रिमोट इंटीरियर्स एंगल जो रहते हैं उनके सम के रहते हैं, अपोजिट टू दिस, और इसका जो एडजेसेंट एंगल है दिस वन, इसको छोड़ के जो रिमेनिंग टू एंगल्स रहते हैं इनके सम के इक्वल एक्सटीरियर एंगल के मेजरमेंट रहते हैं. दैट इज नथिंग बट द एक्सटीरियर एंगल थ्योरम ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल. सो यूजिंग दैट वी गेट हियर EOC इज इक्वल्स टू OAC plus OCA because of this x plus x is equals to, humko mila it is equals to 2x degree. Now, what is here? Jo bhi humne EOC liya, this is actually the center angle. What is this? This is the center angle. Look here, EOC. This one. Ye jo humne consider kiya tha na, this is exterior to this triangle. Kisko exterior tha? Wo is bigger triangle. So, EOC ko exterior tha. So, what is the measurement of this? EOC is nothing but this x plus x, that is equals to 2x. But if you look properly, this angle EOC is nothing but the central angle, right? It is a central angle. So what we can say for this, if it is a central angle, now here, now since it is a central angle, we can simply say that this is a major of EC is nothing but 2x degree. Why? Because the definition of major of an arc means, ab ye jo koi bhi central angle tha, is central angle ki wajah se, ये इस तरीके का आर्क फॉर्म हुआ था. सो द मेजरमेंट ऑफ दिस आर्क इज इक्वल्स टू द मेजरमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल एंगल बिकॉज दिस इज द माइनर आर्क. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ मेजर आर्क, मेजर आर्क की डेफिनेशन क्या कहती है? मेजरमेंट ऑफ माइनर आर्क इज इक्वल्स टू द मेजरमेंट ऑफ अ सेंट्रल एंगल और सिंपली द मेजरमेंट ऑफ अ एंगल इंस्क्राइब बाय द आर्क. सो इसलिए हमने मेजर ऑफ आर्क EC कितना लिया? 2x डिग्री. नाउ लुक एट दिस equation number 1 and the next is the equation number 2. What do we get here? We simply say here these two are equal, OAC and OCA. So we simply say that angle OAC is equals to EAC, which is equals to the half of major of arc EC. Kaise liya? Look here, OAC is equals to EAC. That is OAC. This is OC is equals to what we consider EAC. Ye bigger wala consider the same way. EAC. Now again, this is inscribed. This is inscribed or this is intercepted because of this arc EC. So what I can say that the measurement of this is nothing but the half of this one. Or wahi hame chahiye tha here. So look here. What we get here, that is OAC is nothing but is equals to EAC is equals to half of the major of EC. Now similarly to the next side, jo remaining part tha, usme humne segment OB draw karke, we can prove that EAB is also equals to the half of major of arc B. Now simply add this to EAC plus EAB is equals to half of EC plus half of B. Now if you look properly, EAC plus EAB banke BAC ban raha hai, and EC plus BE, which is getting equals to BDC. And this only we require here. Okay. क्या किया हमने? हमने देखा कि EAC इस आर्क के हाफ है. Next, similarly, we can prove that BAE is half of this BE. Then simply we are added this to. Add करेंगे तो आपको ये total A मिलेगा. That is we get this angle BAC, जो आप get angle BA is equals to half of BE plus half of major of arc EC. And if you look here, if we add this to, this is nothing but arc BEC, or which can be also said as arc BDC. क्योंकि हमारे पास यहाँ पे ये point BA, so it can also be written as it's equals to arc BDC. Therefore, we have proved that angle BAC is equals to half of the major of arc intercepted by. Okay, student. So this was nothing but inscribed angle. So simply, what we have done here? सबसे पहले हमने सिर्फ ये prove किया कि this center angle is equals to the measurement of this EC, and then this OAC is actually the half of EC. So we can say that EAC is also half of EC, and similarly to this side, BAE is also half of BE. And simply, हमने दोनों को add किया, add करके we get that this is equals to half of BD. That is only have to prove. Okay. ये था inscribed angle theorem. आपको सिर्फ उसके definition अच्छे से याद रखनी है. Then next is the corollary. Corollary means what? थ्योरम का यूज करके हमें कुछ प्रूव करना रहता है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ करोलरी. तो व्हाट द करोलरी सेज, द एंगल्स इंस्क्राइब इन द सेम आर्क आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट. सो इट इज ऑब्वियस, अगर सेम आर्क की वजह से कोई दो एंगल फॉर्म हो रहे, तो द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द सेम आर्क विल बी द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द टू आर्क्स विल बी दे आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ईच अदर. नेक्स्टली, द एंगल इंस्क्राइब इन अ सेमी सर्कल इज अ राइट एंगल. ओके, सपोज आई एम हैविंग समथिंग लाइक दिस वे. ओके, आई एम हैविंग दिस सर्कल हियर. Then for this circle, if some arc is inscribed like this, okay, this is one more arc. Then we are having another. If you look properly, if you look here. Here two angles are formed. This is one angle and this one is the another angle. Suppose this is angle A here and this is angle B here, and these two angles is in the same, okay? It is in this arc. Suppose this is C, yes, it is inscribed in same arc here. What we can say that these two arcs are congruent to each other. Singly, angle inscribed in the semicircle. अगर कोई semicircle है, means this is the semicircle. Sorry, ये semicircle नहीं होगा. Whatever angle inscribed in the semicircle, this is the semicircle, right? The two parts divided. जो भी arc इस semicircle में form होगा, suppose this is the angle formed. Obviously, this angle will be equals to 90 degree. Okay, the measurement of this cube. Measure of a inscribed angle is equals to the measure of a arc intercepted by it. Or semicircle ka major arc kya rehta hai? It is equals to 180 degree. The measure of a semicircle or arc inscribed in the semicircle is, sorry, it is not 180, so it's not 90. It is 90 degree. That is, it is the right angle. Therefore, whatever angle is inscribed in there, we can say that is equal to a right. Now, one more theorem we are having. It is very, very important theorem again. The cyclic quadrilateral theorem. बहुत बार पूछा जाता है ये. Inscribe angle तो भी इतना नहीं पूछा जाएगा, but cyclic quadrilateral काफी बार पूछा जाता है. So again, see this. Cyclic quadrilateral, of you know very well, of your closed figure having four vertex, that is called as a quadrilateral. A closed figure having four vertex and edges, that is called as a quadrilateral. Ab cyclic means what? If all the vertices of a quadrilateral lie on the same circle, then it is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. Obviously, cycle ka use jo hai means wahan pe kuch to bhi circle ka aayega. So jo kuch bhi vertices rahege quadrilateral ka, if all the four vertices of quadrilateral is lying on the circle, we will call it as a cyclic quadrilateral. Let's see this help of diagram also. अबे देख, यहाँ पे circle है, this is a circle. And if you look properly, this ADBC, ये जो कुछ भी figure दिख रही है आपको, AD, CV, this is one quadrilateral. And the vertex of all the quadrilateral, or the vertices of all this quadrilateral, that is A, D, C, and B. All the four vertices are lying on the circle only, on the same circle only. We will say that this is nothing but a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so this is a cyclic quadrilateral. So everyone clear about the cyclic quadrilateral? किसी कुछ पूछना है cyclic quadrilateral के बारे में? This is very important, student. Simply, it is very, very easy and the most important, one of the important. All the four vertices. Okay, who is this? Ansari. Yes, beta Ansari Sahishta, aap unmute ho sakte. What do you want to ask? साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल मैंने यहाँ पे एक सर्कल ड्रॉ कर लिया देन ऑन दिस सर्कल आई एम ड्रॉइंग और फिगर ये समथिंग लाइक दिस वे अपना दूसरा कलर चूज करती हूँ ओके फॉर दिस सर्कल आई हैव ड्रॉन समथिंग दिस सर्कल के अंदर मैंने एक रेक्टेंगल बोला है एक क्वाड्रिलेटरल रेक्टेंगल इज अ टाइप ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल ओके सो आई हैव ड्रॉन दिस हियर अ रेक्टेंगल आई हैव ड्रॉन हियर एंड इफ यू लुक प्रॉपरली और वी विल से हियर क्वाड्रिलेटरल ओनली इफ यू लुक प्रॉपरली द वर्टिसेस ऑफ दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल सपोज दिस इज वर्टेक्स बी दिस इज वर्टेक्स बी दिस इज वर्टेक्स सी एंड दिस इज वर्टेक्स डी ऑल द फोर वर्टिसेस ऑफ दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज लाइंग ऑन दिस सर्कल लाइंग ऑन द बाउंड्री ऑफ द सर्कल So this type of figure is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. Means a quadrilateral rehta hai, which is inside the circle, and all the four vertices of the circle is lying on the circle only. So this type of quadrilateral is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, clear? If you look in this figure also, whatever quadrilateral is formed here, the quadrilateral ADBC, all its vertex. Are lying on the circle A, vertex D, vertex C, vertex B. All are lying on the circle. Therefore, it is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, clear? Yes, beta, aaya samajh mein? Okay, hope so. So you understood. Now let's see one of the important theorem based on the cyclic quadrilateral. Again, this theorem has been asked in exam most of the time. So let's see what the theorem says here. So it says that. The opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Now, simply, what is mean by supplementary? Yes, anyone? What is mean by supplementary? Anyone wants to ask? Yes. Okay. Who's this? Yes, Anju, you can unmute yourself and tell me what is mean by supplementary. Yes, beta, aap unmute ho sakte. Anju, again, Ankita, Siddhi, anyone can unmute and tell me what is mean by supplementary. यस बच्चा आपके हैंड रेज है यू कैन हाँ जो नॉट एबल टू हियर यू प्रॉपरली यस अंकिता फ्रॉम तिलक नगर यू कैन ऑल्सो अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ
मिस 90 डिग्री
इट इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री इफ वी आर टेकिंग अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री then the sum of the two complementary angles the sum of two is 90 degree and if we are considering supplementary then it is equals to 180 degree okay so since we have taken the supplementary here so what it says that the opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary suppose I am considering this quadrilateral which is the opposite angle here angle A and angle B So the measurement of this angle means the addition of this two angle is simply is equals to 180 degree. If this happens, we say that the given quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral. Similarly, for the opposite one, okay, you have to consider the angle. This is angle D, and the next is the angle B. And for this, this is angle A plus angle C. The measurement of this two will be equals to 180 degree. So this is called as supplementary and if the opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary to aapko yahan pe kya karna hai we have to prove this so let's start with now this is activity type question activity type question again you know very well few blanks are given to you mean blank boxes are given to you and we have to fill them means 90% answer is already given to us and just the 10% answer we have to fill so firstly since it is a theorem it starts with the given To prove, if I'm having any construction, that construction, and then we'll start the proof. So given, सबसे पहले, the first blank is cyclic. So what will come here? A quadrilateral ADBC, right? This is quadrilateral ADBC is a cyclic quadrilateral. Next we have to prove that angle B plus angle D, which is angle B. Very good. Who's this? Yes, Ankita. Ankita नहीं. कौन है ये? Yes, Nasreen. Angle B plus D is equals to क्या आएगा ये blank box में यहाँ पे yes, this is equals to 180 degree. सारे hand raise से बच्चों, you can unmute yourself. हाँ, ठीक है नसरीन, बहुत जल्दी unmute किया. Okay, again नसरीन, for the next one, look here. What is here? This blank box, angle dash plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. तो C के साथ कौन सा pair आएगा? Yes.
Miss A.
Yes, this is equals to angle A. So angle A plus angle C is equals to 180. तो आपको ये prove करना है यहाँ. So what we are having here? Next we are having this is equals to proof. अब proof कैसे करना? So again this is very very important one. So what is here? Arc ABC is intercepted by the inscribed angle. किसके वजह से inscribed हुआ है? Which arc we are saying? This arc ABC. This arc ABC. is inscribed by the angle ADC. ये bigger angle ADC के वजह से ये यहाँ पे intercept हुआ है, okay? So इसके वजह से intercept हुआ है, तो ADC obviously क्या आएगा? half of major of arc. कौन सा arc आएगा बेटा? A B C. This is equals to half of major of arc ABC. Next similarly dash is inscribed angle intercepted by ADC. अब ADC again this is ADC. किसके इसके वजह से intercept हुआ है? Is an inscribed angle. Again this is nothing but angle ADC. यहाँ पे क्या आएगा again? ADC. This ADC के वजह से यही angle inscribed हुआ है. I will consider. So this is equals to ADC here. Okay. Now the next one. So what do we get here? The major of angle ADC is equals to half of the major of ADC. So simply, what we have to do? Simply add this ADC plus, sorry, what was the other thing? ADC ke opposite kya tha? C wala, okay, center angle C hai. Just look here, jo bhi aayega, is equals to half of the major of arc ACB plus ADC. And since this is equals to this one, the both angle forms is equals to 360 degree. Kyunki wo complete circle form kar raha hai. 360, that is this is equals to 180 degree. Similarly, we can prove that the remaining two angles is also equals to 180 degree here. Look here. Kya prove kiya yahan pe? Sabse pehle ye prove kiya ki ye jo angle ADC hai, ye pure ABC se intercept hua. Then this angle ABC is inscribed because of this ADC. Now simply what we have done, we have added this two. So since we have added this two, what we get, this is it is forming a complete circle. So the major of this complete circle is equals to 360 degree. And since all the measurement of this are because of the inscribed angle is half of the angle intercepted by it, so it is half into 360, so which is get this is equals to 180 degree here. Clear? ठीक है, तो ये था सिंपली सिंपल साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल और थ्योरम ऑफ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल. सो जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस एंड रिमेंबर दैट द अपोजिट एंगल्स ऑफ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल आर 180 डिग्री. तो यही आपको यहाँ पे यूज करना है थ्योरम में. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी वन कोरोलरी व्हिच इज बेस्ड ऑन दिस साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल. व्हाट इट सेज, एन एक्सटीरियर एंगल ऑफ अ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू द एंगल opposite to its adjacent interior angle. Yeah. Simply, an exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is congruent to the angle opposite to its adjacent interior angle. Means, if we are having something like this way, just assume karo ki ye yahan pe touch hua hai. So this is a cyclic quadrilateral, we assume that. Then what happened? An exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral. Ab iska exterior angle kaun sa hai? Suppose yahan pe कुछ तो इस तरीके से एक्सटेंड हुआ. सपोज इट इज एक्सटेंड समथिंग लाइक दिस वे. So ye jo form hua, this is nothing but the exterior angle. So the measurement of this exterior angle or this exterior angle is congruent. Kisko congruent hai? To the angle opposite to its adjacent interior angle. Ab ye hai uska adjacent interior angle. Iska opposite angle ye wala hai. This is opposite to it. So the measurement of this angle, the measurement of this angle and this angle will be equal. These two angles are called as congruent angles. So this is nothing but the corollary of the cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, get that? Simply, जो भी ये exterior angle form हुआ है, इस exterior angle का जो interior angle है, this is interior angle, adjacent interior angle, उसका जो opposite angle रहेगा, it will be congruent to that opposite angle. So this is the corollary for cyclic quadrilateral. Next we are having the converse of cyclic quadrilateral. Simply converse means we go back to forth. So what is here? We are having a pair of opposite angles. If they are supplementary, then we will say that the given quadrilateral is the cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral theorem kya bolta hai? If it is a cyclic quadrilateral, then opposite angles will be supplementary. And opposite kya bol raha hai? Uska converse kya bol raha hai? If for the quadrilateral opposite angles are supplementary, then we will say that the given quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral. Say back to forth. Okay, clear everyone for this? Kisi kuch doubt hai yahan tak? So everything will be clear. Now one more theorem we are having here. So we are not going to prove this theorem, kyunki ye sirf ek theorem humne liya hai. So let's see what the theorem says. Here says that two points on a line, on a given line, sustain equal angles at two distinct points which lie on the same side of the line, then the four points are coincide. Ab agar aap dekhoge to ek line AB hai, and because of this line AB, two arcs are formed, two angles are formed, angle ABD and angle ACD, and both this angle are lying on the same side of this line. Okay, बराबर दोनों एबीडी एंड ईसीडी दोनों एक ही साइड में, ऐसा नहीं कि एक ऊपर है एक नीचे है. दिस इज नॉट हैपेंड. बोथ आर लाइंग ऑन द सेम साइड. सिंस बोथ आर लाइंग ऑन द सेम साइड, वी से दैट दिस फोर पॉइंट, दिस पॉइंट ए, पॉइंट बी, पॉइंट सी एंड पॉइंट डी, दिस फोर पॉइंट्स आर द कोनसाइक्लिक पॉइंट्स. सिर्फ आपको इतना रिमेंबर रखना है, क्योंकि सिर्फ एक ही एग्जाम्पल है बेस्ड ऑन दिस थ्योरम जिसका हमें यूज करना है सॉल्व करने के लिए. सो व्हाट इट सेज, जो भी एक लाइन फॉर्म हुई है, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस लाइन सेगमेंट टू एंगल्स आर ऑन द फॉर्म एंड द टू एंगल्स आर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ दिस साइड, द टू एंगल्स आर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ द लाइन हियर. सो वी से दैट ऑल द फोर पॉइंट्स, ऑल दिस फोर पॉइंट्स ए बी सी डी, ऑल फोर पॉइंट्स आर द कोनसाइक्लिक पॉइंट्स. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द थ्योरम. सो जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट. Okay, now let's start the practice set 3.4. The other examples to nahi hoge, jitne bhi hoge, we'll try to do this. Okay, so here we are having a first question. Adjoining figure. So pehle figure le lete hai. Okay, what is here? We are having here, in this adjoining figure, in a circle with center O, length of chord AB is equals to the radius of the circle. Okay. मेजरमेंट ऑफ कॉर्ड ए बी, ये है आपकी कॉर्ड ए बी, इसकी मेजरमेंट रेडियस के इक्वल, मीन्स ओ ए एंड ओ बी आर द रेडियस एंड ऑल द थ्री मेजरमेंट्स आर इक्वल. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू फाइंड, फर्स्टली वी हैव टू फाइंड द मेजर ऑफ एंगल ए ओ बी, दिस एंगल ए ओ बी. नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड द मेजर ऑफ एंगल ए सी बी, ऑब्वियसली ये दोनों सेम आएगी. ओके, देन द मेजरमेंट ऑफ आर्क ए बी एंड फाइनली द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द मेजर आर्क ए सी बी. ठीक है, सो लेट्स सी हाउ टू प्रूव दिस. सो लुक हियर, फर्स्ट क्या किया हमने, सेगमेंट OA इज इक्वल्स टू सेगमेंट OB, बोथ आर रेडियस, सो वी गेट सेगमेंट OA इज इक्वल्स टू OB इज इक्वल्स टू AB, ऑल दिस थ्री, राइट? व्हाई? क्योंकि कॉर्ड रेडियस के इक्वल दिया है, सो ये तीनों इक्वल आ गए. नाउ सिंस ऑल द थ्री साइड्स ऑफ दिस ट्रायंगल आर इक्वल, व्हाट वी विल से दैट द गिवन ट्रायंगल इज अ equilateral triangle. Why? Because in equilateral triangle, all sides, all the three sides are equal, and each angle is of measurement 60 degree. Yes, tino angles ki measurement kya hogi? 60 degree. So simply I can consider the central angle AOB is equals to 60 degrees. Why? Because each and every angle of an equilateral triangle is equals to 60 degrees. So, the first is completed. आपको AOB find out करना था. So, in this way, we have found out the AOB. Understood आपको AOB? Simply, हमको क्या मिला? The given triangle is nothing but an equilateral triangle. And since each angle of a triangle is 60 degrees, we can directly say that the measure of angle AOB is equals to 60 degrees. Okay? Now, next. अब क्या चाहिए? AC भी चाहिए. अब मेजर ऑफ एंगल सब्सटेंडेड बाय एन आर्क जो थ्योरम है इंस्क्राइब एंगल थ्योरम क्या बोलता है एसीबी दिस एसीबी इज फॉर्म बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एओबी लिखना था यहाँ पे ठीक है दिस ऑफ दिस आर्क एबी वी नो दैट सेंट्रल एंगल माइनर आर्क इस आर्क के इक्वल रहता है so we have this is equal to ठीक है यहाँ पे AOB भी ले सकते so here measure of an angle sustained by arc at a point on the circle is half of the measure of arc sustained by it so what we have half of AOB and AOB is 60 degree so half of 60 that is ACB is equal to 30 degree ठीक है क्या किया हमने ये जो वाला center angle था ना ये जो center angle था ना ACB इस angle के half है So simply it is half. So bada to aapko 60 hai. So half part is nothing but 30 degree. Okay, next what we require? We require the measure of arc AOB. A measure of arc AOB is nothing but a measure of arc AB is nothing but measure of AOB according to the definition of minor arc. Obviously, this is a minor arc. So minor arc kya bolta hai? It is equals to the measure of angle inscribed. जो भी center जिसके वजह से angle form हुआ है, जो भी angle वहाँ पे form हो रहा है, the measurement of this and the arc are equal. So that the measurement of that angle is 60. So measure of arc AB is also equals to 60 degree. Next we require the ACB. ACB is nothing but the major arc. And the measurement of major arc is equals to 360 minus the minor arc here. So 360 minus minor arc is 60. So we get major of arc ACB is equals to 300 degree. ठीक है सबको ये क्वेश्चन समझ में आया एवरीवन किसी कुछ डाउट है इट इज वेरी वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन द इंस्क्राइब एंगल सिर्फ आपको क्या यहाँ पे सिर्फ आपको ये कुछ चीजें याद रखनी है दैट इज इंस्क्राइब एंगल थ्योरम क्या है Based on that theorem, only the full exercise is dependent here. And obviously, the measure of major and minor arc. Clear, everyone? Is kuch puchna hai aata? Nothing? Okay. One hand is raised. Yes, Anju, you want to ask something? Anju, you can unmute yourself. Puchho bhai.
Teacher.
Puchho na.
गुड मॉर्निंग टीचर
गुड मॉर्निंग बोलो
टीचर आपने वो 60 लिया वो अपने मन से लेना है क्या
मन से नहीं लेना है एक इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल फॉर्म हुआ है इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल मींस क्या होता है इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल में सारे साइड्स इक्वल रहते हैं ओके मींस हर एक साइड की मेजरमेंट सेम रहता है सपोज एक साइड 3 है अगर एक साइड की मेजरमेंट 3 है तो रिमेनिंग टू साइड्स की मेजरमेंट 3 रहेंगे दिस इज द 2 सेंटीमीटर दिस इज 3 सेंटीमीटर दिस इज 3 सेंटीमीटर ओके इन इक्विलैटरल द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ऑल द 3 साइड्स आर इक्वल एज वेल एज द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ऑल द 3 एंगल्स आर आल्सो इक्वल तीनों एंगल्स की मेजरमेंट भी सेम रहती है अब 60 कैसे आएगा तो सबको पता है द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ऑल द 3 एंगल्स ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल इज 180 डिग्री अब तीनों सेम है मींस एक्चुअली 180 डिवाइडेड बाय 3 होता है सो हर एक एंगल की मेजरमेंट क्या हो जाती है यहाँ पे इक्वल्स टू 60 डिग्री क्यों क्योंकि ये इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल है सिंस इट इज एन इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी एंगल इज इक्वल्स टू 60 डिग्री मन से नहीं लिया वो हमने इक्विलैटरल ट्रायंगल है ये प्रूव किया और इक्विलैटरल है इसलिए हर एक एंगल इक्विलैटरल का 360 रहता है दिस इज द ट्रूथ थिंग इसलिए वी आर टेकन दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 60 ओके क्लियर एनीवन एल्स वांट्स टू आस्क समथिंग यस अंजू समझ में आया ना बेटा ओके ठीक है ओके लेट्स सी क्या टाइम हुआ है ओके देखते हैं एक क्वेश्चन होता है या नहीं कितना बड़ा है उस पर डिपेंड है। So I think we should stop here. Question नहीं कंप्लीट हो। Yes, किसी कुछ पूछना है up to this? Okay, students, so we'll stop here. Yes, ma'am, I have completed.